written in July 2nd, 2003 by Philip Wyburn, we discover the story of Zeus and Celia. In this story, Zeus is a god who falls in love with Celia. Celia is a regular person in this world, and Zeus is married. Zeus comes down from the kingdom, and his wife does not agree with it. Zeus falls in love with her, and once his wife finds out, she sends a message to Celia, and Celia reads this and is very upset. She is the spirit of the weeping willow, and she turns into a tree. Once Zeus finds out that she turned into a tree, assuming his wife has something to do with it, he goes and he talks to his wife. His wife lets him know that she did this, and then he goes back to talk and talks to Celia. Then Celia is very upset and does not want to talk to him at all. And then once he insists, then he insists. Celia does not want to talk to him ever again. Celia is very upset, and she cries and she cries, and her tears reach the ground, and her branches are stretched, and her leaves reach and touch the ground, and her roots are stretched all over, and that is how the weeping willow is transformed. So in this, the weeping willow is a very spiritual and a medical tree, and it helps people emotionally. So this tree brings a sense of spirit, a sense of medicine, and a sense of literature. First, I will mention how it has helped the Native Americans spiritually, medically, and how it is still a sign. It has still helped literature in a way of literature up to today. So the Native Americans picture it as a sign of protection for them. So it is a sign of protection for them because of its big roots. The roots can grow up to 50 feet, and they can crack the roads because of how strong they are. They also look at it as a sign of longevity because of their growth. According to the article in Urban Day Foundation, they can grow up to 30 to 40 or up to 50 feet tall. The tree is also used for medicine. The way that they can use it for medicine is the people back then would use to chew, or they would chew the leaves as well. This chewing of the tree and of the bark would help them lower and reduce pain and fever, and also reduce toothache. Because of this, the tree was also named the toothache tree. It has salicin, which is an element in aspirin, and that is how it would help it reduce all of the fever. It would help them reduce all of the pain and all of the toothache. The way that we do this is that we take out the inner part of the bark. They would boil it. They would boil the leaves, or they would also chew it. And they would just drink it as normal tea. So it has not only influenced Native Americans spiritually, not only has it helped in medicine, but it is also influencing in literature today. So it has helped in society as well, because up to now, it is still being used in literature. So it is being used in Harry Potter books, specifically in the Harry Potter books, The Prisoner of Azkaban, written by J.K. Rowling in the year of 1999. In this book, it is described to be a very violent tree that moves its leaves from side to side, and it is hurting every person who is around it. It is also used in William Shakespeare in the song, The Willow Song, and in The Willow Song, it talks about a lost love when the woman loses her lost love, and she's very upset. In both of these stories is you can see how they are hurt and how they are crying, which reflects back to the story of Suze and Celia, where they are being both hurt and they are both crying. The trees have helped spiritually, medically, and in literature. They have made an impact on our ancestors, and they are in history, and they are still making an impact on us up to today.